Namaste, I'm Suni Lama from Nepal. Today I'm going to talk about my research entitled Assessment of the Impacts of Livestock Grazing on Endangered Red Panda Habitat in Eastern Nepal. So first of all, giving a general overview about this species, red panda is a unique member of order Carnivora, but almost entirely depends on its vegetarian diet. Red panda distribution is confined in the eastern Himalayas in temperate bamboo forests in southwestern China, Nepal, India, Bhutan, and Myanmar. It is listed as endangered in the Asian Red Data Book. The objectives of the research is to determine the effects of livestock grazing on red panda habitat and also to provide information on the habitat preferences of red panda. Also, to know the perspectives of local residents regarding the red panda conservation. The specific site includes two community forests of Ilam district of eastern Nepal. Moving on, data filtering and processing. The line transect sampling method was used. Field protocol was followed from Ministry of Forest and Soil Conservation. In total, 15 linear transects of an average length of 800 meters were delineated in the community forest. In this transect, 10 by 10 meter plots were demarcated where livestock droppings and red panda indirect evidence were recorded. Based on the presence of indirect signs, plots were distinguished as red panda only plot, livestock only plot, habitat overlap plots, and non-sign plot. Questionnaire survey and key informant interviews were conducted for the locals. Talking about the research findings, in total, 21 different tree species were recorded from red panda potential habitat area. Here listed are some of the common species preferred by red panda. Red panda only plots and habitat overlap plots presented a higher diversity index for tree species. Talking about the descriptive statistics for different vegetation layers. The bamboo abundance was maximum in red panda only plot. Canopy coverage in different plot types ranged from 40 to 60% with red panda only plot to have the highest coverage. However, the percentage coverage of the shrub layer was comparatively greater in livestock only plot, specifically in red panda only plot and habitat overlap plot. Pellets were spotted within 160 meter distance from the nearest water source. The given maps here shows a significant overlap in the resources shared by livestock and red panda. Green patches represents the potential red panda habitat, which was determined from National Red Panda Survey 2016. This gave us a basis to interpret red panda distribution and livestock interferences in the study area. 69.7% of the surveyed livestock plots substantially overlaps with the potential habitat of red panda. So from the questionnaire survey conducted, 87.5% of the total herders are unaware about the conservation importance of red panda. Besides, every key informant interview believed that the extensive grazing practices within the forest is causing detrimental impact on the natural resources and wildlife habitat. Also, there are other ongoing threats such as hazard resource collection, poaching, timber harvesting as shown in the figure in this region. To sum up, unsustainable grazing has negatively affected the occurrence and habitat of red panda. The lack of effective strategies has led in the hazard grazing. Local herders should be well trained about sustainable herding practices. Moreover, the formulation of discrete national policy for livestock management will somehow help in the minimization of arising problems. Thank you.